I have some sad news. Many of the bees in my backyard apiary have either passed away or are paralyzed, like this bee here that you can see under the microscope. I'm going to show you how I use this wireless microscope to discover what happened to try to solve for this problem in the future. It's awful when this happens. And unfortunately, she's paralyzed. She's making involuntary movements with her legs. And she's been doing that for the better part of the day since I found her during the inspection. It's really sad to see. Just to talk a little bit about the microscope, I found out about the microscope by going to the Illinois State Beekeepers Association. David Burns was one of the keynote speakers, and he talked about being a citizen scientist, which is a really cool concept. It's the idea that as a beekeeper, you should also figure out how bee anatomy works, do a little bit of research yourself. And that's something that really resonates with me personally, because you know me from my channel, I'm always researching. Another cool thing about this is that you can take it out to the apiary because it's completely handheld and you can record things that are going on. As an example, this is a picture of my shirt. You can see the threads in it. I think it's kind of a cool microscope. I definitely think that this kind of technology can be hugely helpful in the beekeeping industry. I will give you a quick disclaimer on this product. Unfortunately, the software sucks. I did look for other microscopes. There are some that are really cool. I'll post some links. They actually have screens on them, so you could go out to your apiary. And rather than fumbling around with two devices, you can have the device directly embedded in here. And a lot of them are made for children, but they still have the 1000x magnification like this one does, which is hugely important. And then they all have this scroll wheel, which you're able to use to focus in on the areas that you want to be able to see. They have an LED that's adjustable, which is kind of cool. I could also focus in and then make a video of something that I want to record and be able to show, for example, to my state inspector in order to see what the problem is. And it comes with a nice stand that kind of looks like a microscope. Allows you to be able to set it up hands-free so that I'm able to just focus on the picture itself. One of the ways that you can tell that a bee has been poisoned is that their proboscis, or their tongue, is sticking out. It's a telltale sign that you oftentimes see after a farmer sprays their field or one of your neighbors has pesticide put on their flowers. Had I known, I would have closed up my hive for the day, and this would not have been a problem. It would have been a lost day of foraging, but it would have been a much better scenario than what I have now. I will be talking to my homeowners association, and I've also recently signed up for Bee Check, which, if you've not heard of it before, it allows farmers in the area to be able to tell you when they are going to be spraying and also informs them that there's a beekeeper in the area. Take a look in the links below. It's a free service. If you're getting value out of this content, please make sure that you like the video and subscribe below.